Riley. I'm here to put you to rest for good.
Who even writes this shit now?
Certainly not Adam. He's just cashing checks at this point.
Yeah. Sure.
Thanks for coming in, Frankie. We'll be in touch.
It's Franklin, actually.
Yeah, whatever.
Dylan Porter, you're up next.
Hey, my name's Dylan Porter. I'm repped by the Risher Agency.
Okay, hold on. I gotta go. Yeah, go ahead.
Hello, my name's Dylan Porter. I'm repped by the Risher Agency, and I'm reading for Michael.
Dylan Porter. How do I know that name? Do I know you, Dylan?
I don't think so.
Now, come on, tell me how.
I couldn't tell you.
Oh, wait, Porter. Wait. Are you related to Chase Porter?
Yeah, that was my dad.
Oh, man. Your dad and I worked back together on Chainsaw 3. Well, you were just like a little dude. Oh, I love it.
Oh, that's wild.
Yeah.
I don't remember any of that, unfortunately.
Yeah, I'm sorry. You know, he really was one of the good ones.
Yeah.
Unfortunate what happened to him.
Yeah. Yeah, thanks.
That's right, you're Heather Langenkamp's kid too, aren't you?
Yeah, I'd really rather not talk about all that, if that's okay.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Let's get on with the scene. And when you're ready, just give Justin a nod.
Sure.
Interior rundown shed, Honey Island Swamp, night. All three survivors, Andrew, Rose, and Michael, are all regrouping after Victor Crowley's last attack.
We can't keep this up. Do you both hear me? We can't keep doing this. We run, we hide, Crowley finds us, Crowley kills someone. I mean, that's the sick joke of this whole situation. We're trapped in a swamp, full of hiding places, but there is nowhere to hide. Not from him. Not even walls keep him out.
So what's your point?
My point, Rose, is if we can't hide, why are we still trying? We can't just wait around for that freak like you two did. That's what got my sister killed. I can tell you one thing for sure. If she were here with us now, she'd agree with me.
He was pushed into a jet engine and he still came back. He's cursed to come back every day like new, remember?
Yeah. Yeah, well, if there's a curse, there's a way to break it. Otherwise, he kills, he dies, he just keeps coming back. More people die. Good people. Like Heather. Well, I'm not gonna let that happen. Even if I have to do this by myself, I'm killing that murderer for good. Is that okay? I can try something different if you want me to.
Oh, I think we've all seen.
Enough!
Jesus Christ!
Oh, Dylan. look what's become of you.
That voice. I know that voice.
Dead. We killed you. We killed you once and
once
for all.
Once and for a time, maybe. But never once and for all. Face it, Dylan. You may be all grown up, but you're still my little bitch.
It's a fucking dream. You're not real, and I need to wake up. Wake up!
Hey, Dylan. Little piggy, we never got to play our favorite game. Skin the cat!
Dylan.
Sorry, Doc. What was that?
I was asking how you hurt yourself.
Oh, yeah. I think it was a cabinet was stuck. I just gave myself a shiner.
I see.
Dylan, what's really bothering you?
Had a nightmare last night.
Tell me about it.
It was another audition dream.
Well, plenty of working actors have those. It's hardly anything to worry or be embarrassed about.
Two people died this time.
What do you mean, two people died? How?
So the two people next to the casting director committed suicide. One shot himself and the other slit her own throat.
Why do you think they did that?
It was a dream. I don't know. Why does anything happen in a dream?
Dreams can mean a multitude of different things, almost all of which can be applied as some kind of lesson to the person who psychologically created them in the first place.
I don't know if there was a lesson in this one, Doc. Am I supposed to wear a splash guard to my next audition?
Using humor to cope with scary situations is an old-school tactic, Dylan. But not one proven to be very effective.
Maybe that's why I'm an actor, not a comedian.
Did the subject of your parents come up?
Yeah, the
casting director recognized me from when I was a kid. He was asking about my dad.
And your mother? Did he ask about her too?
Yeah, her too.
Have you checked in on her lately?
Who?
Your mother.
Why? Answer's always the same. She's not well enough to come to the phone. Same old loony bin, different day. Well, I try, you know, it just hurts.
You know, maybe your casting director brought her up because you're feeling guilty about not checking in.
Maybe.
Trust me, Dylan, I understand your hesitation to check in on her, especially when there doesn't ever seem to be any positive progress. But that same hesitation can feed your subconscious guilt like a sleeping giant. That guilt can slowly build up over time and eventually, in most cases, come exploding out at the most inopportune moment. The very act of checking in on her to see how she's doing can act as sort of a pressure release valve for your guilt. That way, even though you may continue to get the answer you're not looking for, at least you tried.
Yeah, maybe that's true.
What about the casting director?
What do you mean?
Well, you said the other two people died, but what happened to the casting director? Did they kill themselves also?
He laughed at me.
That's it?
Yeah.
Are you sure? If so, this is the place to discuss it. Dylan, are you sure there was nobody else in your dream?
I said no. He laughed at me, and, I left. You know?
Dylan, we've been working professionally together for a number of years. Having learned your history over that time, I can't imagine what you went through when your mother started getting confused. It had a lot to do with her horror films, from what I understood from her doctor. When we started this journey, you mentioned that you had been exposed to those films at a young age as well. I just want to be sure that you're having these dreams is not symptomatic of a resurgence of your childhood trauma.
They're not.
Are you getting your rest?
It's been manageable, Doc. I think I have it under control.
All right, well, I'm going to have to trust you on that, Dylan. But please, promise me that if anything changes, if your life starts to be call me in, come back, and I'll prescribe something. No way you can get any resistance to you. Dylan.
No, I think I'm okay.
Unfortunately, our time is up.
Yeah.
We're going to have to pick this up next session. But let me suggest in the future that you don't wait until the end of the session to bring up something that could have tremendous implications for your mental health.
Yeah. No, that's fair. You got it. Nightmares first next time.
I'm not afraid to die. Hey, my name is Dylan Porter. I was calling, hoping to speak with my mother, Heather, if she's available.
Oh, is she on staff here?
No, she's a patient.
Oh, I apologize. And you said her name was Heather? Heather Porter?
Oh, no, not Heather Porter. Heather Langenkamp?
Oh, yes. I believe I've spoken to you before. Let me just see if she's available to come to the phone. Can you hold?
Yeah, no problem. Hi, yeah, I'm here.
I'm sorry, but Miss Langenkamp is not feeling up to coming to the phone.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to try back again in a few weeks, we can see if she's feeling up to it then.
Yeah, of course. Can you just keep me posted if anything changes? Yeah, you too. Thanks. Fuck you, Freddy.
Testing, testing. These damn batteries aren't going out on me again, are they? Updating the files on Dylan Porter. Porter seems to be regressing back to the paranoid state of his childhood. When I tried to dive deeper into the subject, Dylan's guard immediately raised. I fear Dylan may be making a return to his childhood delusions. But can they really be taking the same form as before? That character from his mother's films? What is really concerning to me is that Dylan is around the same age as his mother when she was first hospitalized.
I fear I may be seeing the same psychosis in Dylan.
To think all these delusions brought on by a cheap horror movie. Damn it, I knew it.
Recognize a cheap horror movie when you see one.
Freddy.
Sometimes.
How are you real?
That's my little secret.
Damn you.
They've tried. Time's up, Doc!
Hello?
Dylan? It's Mom.
Mm-hmm.
at night, I won't wake up. He keep creeping right, trying to break off. See the fingerprints and he's able to rip my face off. I can feel the pain, I'm unable to break away from. But I won't fall, I'm a goddamn beast. And they call me T-Rex when I chop on beats. Ready to get strikes when I fight for the feast. Got the city on lock when I stop on the street. Motherfuckers wanna talk like I'm all for the meds. Everything I seen is all in my head. Got plenty of demons on in my bed. But none of them are breathing, they think that I am dead. But no, I'm alive and stuck in a time where people are dying around me and crying. Sick of the violence, people are fine with fingers are flying. Now everybody's silent. Never gonna sleep again, never gonna sleep again. Never gonna sleep again, never gonna sleep again. I'm gonna go get all my revenge.
Go!
Got a plan, I'ma put to bed. I gotta stand up and make a sense.
Yeah!
Fuck Freddy and his tilt to brim. I'm gonna cook up his face again. And by the way, that he keep after me, hacking his session is right through my family. I think he mad at me, following back at me. Time for the tragedy, now I am damaging everything that he could possibly throw at me. Promise you that you will not get a hold of me. Turning the tables, now you try avoiding me. I am the monster and you are the boy to me. Never gonna sleep again. Never gonna sleep again. Never gonna sleep again. Never gonna sleep again. Yeah, my nightmares I am fighting till I see everyone die. He killed them all and now he's going through my head to terrorize. Fuck you, Freddy, now I'm ready and your death will come and die. Catch him slipping while I'm sleeping. Leave him leaking blood inside. He died. My nightmares I am fighting till I see everyone die. He killed them all and now he's going through my head to terrorize. Fuck you, Freddy, now I'm ready and your death will come and die. Catch him slipping.
You thought you'd grown up. Finally woke up from the things that you.